They're all gone. It can't be true. They're all gone.
All gone.
What would the world be like without semiconductors? I'm Nicole Scott. I'm the co-founder of Mobile Geeks and a video journalist. Today I'm at Bosch doing a little bit of investigative reporting, trying to find some semiconductors. I'm going to meet Emma, so hopefully I'll be able to learn all about semiconductors.
Hi. I'm Nicole.
Yeah, great to meet you, Nicole. Hi, my name's Emma and I'm an engineer here at Bosch in Reutlingen, which makes me an expert in semiconductors.
Perfect, I have a million questions for you.
That's great, should we get started?
Yes.
Brilliant, let's go inside.
It looks very techy.
Yeah.
So I had a terrible dream last night that I lived in a world without semiconductors.
Well, that must have been truly awful because they are everywhere.
They're even in my smartwatch, right?
Yeah, sure, they're in your smartwatch. They open your garage door when you come home at night. They're in your toothbrush when you brush your teeth. They heat your house up in the morning. They are literally everywhere.
Now, can you show me what it looks like? Can we actually see inside my smartwatch?
Yeah, sure, of course we can. Should we open it?
Yes. Ah, we have lab coats.
Yep, grab a coat and grab some safety glasses.
So where exactly are we?
So today we're in the training lab.
So you actually got it open. Here it is.
Yeah, we got it open and now we can see all the semiconductors that are inside.
And so you have a tiny little chip there.
Here we have one of the chips from the backside of this PCB. This is an inertial measurement unit. It has three gyroscope and three acceleration sensor axes. So real moving parts in here on a microscopic level and an electronic circuit which interprets all of those signals.
So how exactly is a semiconductor made?
Well, did you know basically they're made out of sand?
No.
So we start off with quartz sand. This quartz sand is melted down to create a really pure silicon base. Then we pull a monocrystalline crystal out of this sand, saw it into strips, which are then called wafers. And with these wafers, we then go into a production facility like we have here and build complicated 3D structures for electronic circuits, but also mechanical structures.
So there's all of those sensors and a tiny brain in that very small chip?
Yes, it does.
That's really impressive.
Yeah, and it's not just impressive in your phone or in your watch. We also have them in cars.
Really? Can we take a look? Now this is a really cool car.
In every modern car, there are hundreds of semiconductors all working together in the safety systems like airbag and electronic stability control, but also for comfort functions like air conditioning or heating, going all the way around to finding out where you are. Just simple navigation is also semiconductors.
Cool, I didn't know there were so many semiconductors in a car. Yeah, thanks so much for having me.
You're welcome. It'd be great to have you again sometime.
Oh, you know I'll be back. I think the most interesting part of my day was learning how semiconductors are made and how they fit into everything. They're really, really small, and they're really in all parts of our society. They're everywhere.